At this point, carburetor is pretty loose, you can see here.
All right.
So we got two things we got to do on it. One that we can do before rotating it is we have to open this top slide on it right here, open up the slide, replace the needle, replace a couple spacer washers on it, and then put it back together. You just have to move a couple of these cables out of the way. I didn't have to take them off or anything. If this hasn't been opened before, which I don't think this carburetor has been, the screws will probably be tough to get open the first time you get it.
Right.
And what you just want to remember is that you definitely do not want to strip the screws.
No stripping screws.
So what you want to do is you find the exact screw that's the exact right size for it, not too big and not too small. So we'll do the old test fit and make sure it's right. Then when you go to take it out, you push down to make sure it won't slip when you're taking it out.
And also, don't you want to apply a little bit of pressure to the top because of the spring that's in?
Yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm not going to take them all out at first. I'm just going to loosen them all up. And then after we've got them all loose, and it depends on how sticky your gasket is too, because there is like a little...
there is a little seal on it.
They call it a diaphragm, but it's like a little rubber gasket. Yep. It's a diaphragm, but it moves with the air pressure.
Mm-hmm.
And it's got a spring under the slide. So if it... I've seen them stick before. If it sticks, then it won't want to come out, and you'll have to actually pull it out carefully.
Right.
You need to be careful with the diaphragm. It's small, it's rubber, it's fragile, and if you tear it, your carburetor's done, you have to get a new one, it's $100.
Yep.
You don't want to do it.
Don't want to do that.
The replacement diaphragms are $100, anyway, so I'm just going to loosen up all the screws. I don't know if this carburetor has been into before or not by anyone else, and we'll tell in a minute because we'll look at the EPA plug on the bottom, and if the EPA plug has been drilled out before, we know somebody will have been into it. Speaking of which, Wayne, you do have a drill?
Yes. Yes, I do have a drill.
All right, let's let it loose and let's see if it's popping up. Okay, so you can see it's like a little loose.
Yep.
It doesn't feel like it's very loose. I don't know if it has much spring pressure on it. I'm going to go ahead and take out these screws.
All right. I'm just going to add a little touch pressure to it. That way we don't have going on.
So this will probably, it feels like it's probably going to be about the same as mine. It's just going to gently lift off. And we're just going to carefully do it because you really don't want to mess up that slide. Just slowly and gently do it. And I'm going to take it off the cap right now. Gently taking it off of it.
All right.
You're going to see the screw here. You're going to see this is what holds the needle. Just remember how this went in, because you got to put it back in the same way. You can put it in reverse. You don't want to. It won't work.
Yep.
So just remember this. I'm just going to lay it on the ground right there like how it came out. And now we're going to take out the diaphragm, which is the diaphragm, slide, and needle. And we're just going to carefully take it out.
And there is...
No rips, no tears. It looks good. And there's your needle in it right there.
Ta-da.
You'll notice this is a stock needle. It has no spacers on it. Just one setting. That's all it is. But we've got a replacement.
This guy here, we have the Dyno Jet Kit for improved durability, throttle response, and horsepower. So here is our kit, and it comes in a nice little plastic sealed case with our new jet spacers, clips, mixture settings, springs, and an actual drill bit.
So this is the tricky part, because it gives you the needle. And it gives you a clip and two spacers. So we've got a needle, which there's a bunch of little spaces you can see on it where the clip can go. What Dyno Jet says to do is to put it in the third one from the top, which is the middle third from the top, and just push it on. You can hear it click and like snap in once you've got it on all the way.
And there it is.
A little snap.
Yep.
You can see it's on there all the way. So what it should show us here is that we've got our needle going into the slide. Then we've got two spacers on top of that, and then this bad boy, and then the replacement spring.
Right.
So we should have a replacement spring in your kit as well.
We do. We got a replacement spring. So, as we were talking about, it goes in the place E-clip and groove 3 from the top.
To mock up how it's going to go, we're going to have our slide. The needle's going to go into it. We're going to put these two spacers on top. The other little plastic holder is going to go on top of that, and then the spring's going to go on top of that, and then the top. Right. So what we're going to have here, we've got our slide, Yep. This bad boy goes on top of it, and then our spring will go on top of that. So I'm just gonna slowly let this ride down with the spring in it. Our new spring.
Yep.
Slowly fit in. We're gonna go ahead and put that one back in there. I don't know if you can tell, but you've got a little hole
at the bottom.
Inside the bottom that your needle has to go into. So. And it should just fall right in there once you've got it aligned right. After that, you'll just want to make sure that you have the spring back on this thing when you put it back together. You can tell there's like three little metal
tabs
here that will go inside of that spring. And now
does that diaphragm need to sit in like any type of channel or anything like that?
It has a channel that it goes in and sits in, and you can sort of feel this. It doesn't move. It doesn't move any side to side, which means that diaphragm is centered there.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm just going to be really careful again because these are steel screws going into an aluminum.
Don't you just want to get them?
Yeah, we'll get them a little loose.
A little loose. Tighten them down. Yeah. That way we can star pattern tightness, but not He-Man, Superman style tight.
Going across thread it.
So. Yeah.
Make sure it feels like it's seated all the way before.
That looks natural.
Yep, so I'm just going to tighten it up and make sure they're all snug.
All right, so cool.
I think we're all snug there. So now is when we're going to try and rotate this carburetor. I'm just making sure nothing's catching on anything.
All right.
All right.
There we go.
And there we go.